animals held a competition to see who would be their new king. It was called a challenge. Everyone took part in the challenge, but it was always elephant who won year after year. This year, Morton wanted to leave his soft, dark bed in the soft, dark earth to go to the challenge. He was tired and bright light outside hurt his eyes, but he knew he had to go and help choose a king, even though elephant always won. Mor brushed his shiny black coat and went up into sunshine. But bright light blinded him, and he bumped straight into something on the path. It was a wall and feather, and it looked as it were a heart. Bermel ran to get a drink of water. "Oh, thank you. I flew too high and banged my head on the sky," sobbed the bird. Mole said, "I must go to the challenge, but I'll put you in my backpack and take you with me. You will be quiet and safe." As hurried on the mole explained, every year there is a challenge. Decide who becomes king. Last year the challenge, who was to pick the steers, and elephant won. Asked Bert. "Of course, Simon. The year before, it was who waited for and elephant won." Asked Bert. "Of course, Simon. It was the year the eldest won't even. You had the longest nose. You can guess who won that." "Elephant," said Bird. "Tell me, Mom, the king." "Of course," replied Mom. Is the elephant always king?" asked Bird. "Always," said Mom sadly. "He has been king for as long as I can remember." The other animals were already gathered for the challenge. Mole was a bit afraid for other hoofs and paws and claws. His black velvet fur was soon dusty and dirty. Then the ground shook and four huge grey feet crashed past beneath two sharp white trunks. King Elephant did not see swirled. King Elephant blew a blast on his long trumpet. Noise flapped his big grey ears. He blared, "For this year's challenge, I shall throw mango in there. Will I catch it or be king?" Mole said, "I wanted to see how I could win. What chance of catching a mango?" "Come on, you stubborn feet," and excited Mole. "Dare not me." King Elephant whirled his trunk around once, and the mango flew high into the air. But Mole's all rushed forward. Gazelle was hopeful. She reached her head up high. She opened her mouth wide so she had tiger and rhino and all the other animals, even Mom, held out two black paws, although his eyes were shut tight against the dust and the sun. Then out of the mole's backpack flew Bird so fast that no one saw her in the clouds of dust. She flew straight up like a ball from a kick. Atop of trees, sticking her sharp beak through its bill. So she flew down again. Who caught it? Who? Everyone was asking her friends. Look, Buzzard. He crossed his arms and looked hit and silent. There was no longer there. He caught neither, he bellowed. Oh, whispered Mole. I did mean. Yes, I must have either. Sure enough, that in his form lay the language. Hooray for Mole! Mole is king, shouted the animals. Elephant cropped him just for practice. Now I'm standing rolls using all of your projects. Chapter 2. Mole's little heart sank from ailment. He had fought, no, of course. The winner was always elephants. Again, elephant whirled his trunk around each fast. To time up, he went mango like a rocket. One fine night so high that no one on the ground could see it. Hopeful animals rushed forward and banged into one another paws, out their mouths. Open or wanting to be king, even Mole put his paws against Low. His eyes were shut tight at Mole's backpack. Two birds so fast that no one saw her as made. But just she caught up with the mango as it reached its mouth, sticking her sharp beak into its lost flesh, she plunged back down. Who caught it? Him? There was a trusses among us. But elephant was looking short. Grumpy, he squinted at the tip of chunk. There was no mango. He caught the mango, though. I did. He's choking down his between his paws. Oh, well done! No. Cried all the animals, except Elephant. You are such a good catcher. I wasn't ready, said Elephant. We'll try it again. Mole's disappointed little heart felt like a wrist mangled. This time, Elephant whirled his trunk faster than the proper of helicopter. He let go of mango flew so high, it almost splattered against sky-eager animals. Rushed forward. Up went Frank first, catching the mango at the very top of the sky. As we flew down, back down, she saw the mole. His snout was up. His eyes were shut tight and the little face was open. Who caught the mango? Bellowed Elephant. Mole blinked his eyes and stared at the mole. Blinked his eyes at the mole. He started at the lushy mango in his paws. I did it, he said. That's a chance, he said. I've got some. The other animals let out a noisy roar. Play fair, Mole, is the king. He caught the mango three times. bird poked her head out of Ma's backpack as if she had just woken up. "What's happened?" she asked shyly. Ma explained how he fought Womanga 3 times and now he is king for a year. "And what helpful, gentle king are you?" When Meg said word, he quelled animals. Elephant Fort said nothing. He was looking dizzy, peering up, his trunk still hoping to find